Imperial population has definitely increased.
Huh. What's that?
Look down, the Great Tree of Origins.
Is that fog?
It doesn't look like the fog we saw with the ghost ship.
Yes, it's localized entirely around the Great Tree. It almost resembles a cocoon of sorts.
Has the Great Tree always been able to do that?
No. I've never seen it do this before. What's happening here?
Look at that!
Primordials?
They look like the one that attacked the village. Those primordials predate the Eternian era.
How is that possible? Are you saying those primordials came from the fog?
We can't determine anything from up here, at all.
Well...
Indeed. We don't know when it might come under attack again. Like Hummel said, the Great Tree may very well be the cause. Let's check in with the village before we make our way to the Great Tree.
Yeah! Yeah.
Please, have some. It's done!
Thank you.
should have reached the temple by now.
Huh? Did we miss it?
What are you saying? We couldn't have missed it.
Hey, is the path supposed to be this long?
No. Something is clearly amiss here.
I don't sense any Saurians. What's going on?
Only way we'll find out is if we keep moving.
Is everyone here?
Yes, we are.
I have a bad feeling about this. Everyone, be careful.
What's going on?
Why, that's the same symbol as Donna?
Just showed up out of the blue.
Why the hell does that all have it?
You
you received that exact same symbol after you fought a primordial in the fog. What?
Everyone, look!
Surrounding the great tree is expanding.
What's going on?
The evolution of the world, begun anew by the great tree of origins.
Something's coming from the fog.
That's the robed fellow we saw at the Valley of Kings. But who are the others?
They're monsters!
A thousand pardons for bewildering you. Let us begin by introducing ourselves. My name is Hydra.
I am Minos. Upon closer examination, you humans are far more frail-looking than I had expected.
My name is Nestor. I do not require that you commit it to memory. Nevertheless, we are well met.
And I am Ura.
You are Adol, I presume. We wish you no harm.
Really?
I'm skeptical, but I suppose we should hear them out.
So who are you?
Selection and rejection. As I mentioned before, this process is the means by which the Great Tree fosters evolution. We are the Wardens of Evolution. Beings who have been tasked with overseeing that process.
The Wardens of Evolution? What you said earlier, the evolution of the world begun anew by the Great Tree of Origins? What does that mean?
It is beyond your ken. The Lacrimosa has visited this world many times over the ages. That humans now claim dominion over this world will not forestall the inevitable.
You mean...
Exactly. The same fate that befell the Eternians will befall you. Humans have been rejected for the coming evolution.
What?
Unfortunately, yes, the Lacrimosa will bring forth a cataclysm, which varies in accordance with the era. The resurgence of the prehistoric world unfolding before your very eyes, that is, in fact, the Lacrimosa of this era.
Its effects are currently confined to this island, but in due time, it will spread across the world. So it has been decided, since time immemorial.
This has got to be some kind of joke. We're getting out of here and going back to our normal lives.
These are understandable reactions. I sympathize with your plight, but there is nothing I can do.
Not once in the entire span of existence has a species thrived forever. By necessity, the species must be renewed to maintain the world.
Simply put, the Lacrimosa is the natural law of the world. All living creatures must accept its judgment.
No.
Anomalous Donna and Anil!
Indeed they do. What does that mean?
Donna? No.
It seems you've remembered. When the Lacrimosa comes, a single individual is selected from the species facing extinction. That individual will then witness the destruction of their own species. In doing so, the cycle of selection and rejection will be perpetuated for all eternity. We, the Wardens of Evolution, are those chosen.
You, Donna, are the chosen Warden of the Eternian Era. It is only right that you be by our side.
Donna, then...
The symbol on your arm, Adol, is proof that you've been selected to be a Warden. That is why we have come to greet you.
Why was Adol chosen?
Only the brightest soul among the species facing extinction is selected to become a Warden. As the selected soul, you are beholden to this fate. Now cease your resistance and join us.
No. We refuse to accept this!
What a pity.
We are merely overwhelmed by the gravity of our sudden revelation. Nothing more. For now, we will take our leave.
You will see us again. Steel yourselves.
Until we meet again, Donna.
Wait!